The occasion is the European Alliance for Personalised Medicine's Regulatory Affairs Working Group in the European Parliament, December 2014. It's also the launch of the STEPS interest group of MEPs, and four attended: Kay Swinburne, Nessa Childers, Philip De Backer, and Christian Bassoy.
David Byrne, former health commissioner. Great advances obviously been made in personalised medicine and in the health arena as a whole. How much has that changed since you were health commissioner?
Well, there's been huge progress in the development of science since I was in the commission 10 years ago. During my time, a lot of our time was taken up with global communicable diseases, SARS, avian influenza, mad cow disease, and such like. We've moved on from that. Many of these issues have been dealt with, although they're still there. We must always be vigilant. But we've now got the opportunity and the time to engage in research and to derive the benefits from that. And many of the benefits from scientific research is now going in the direction of health, and in particular the phenomenon of personalized medicine, particularly since the discoveries from the Genome Project and everything that has come from that. We can now fit medicines to the DNA of a patient, to the DNA of a particular disease. This is a huge development, and we have the opportunity now to get the benefit of that. But to succeed in getting the benefits for patients, we need to put a regulatory regime in place in the European Parliament and together with the Council of Ministers to ensure those benefits are properly derived for patients, whether that's data protection, whether that's ensuring that the clinical trials regulation is effectively operating for the benefit of patients. These are the important issues. But ultimately, all of this is intended to be for the benefit of the patient. So the translation of all of that to the delivery of drugs and treatment to the patients at the right time is of paramount importance and the object of the exercise.
We all share a common objective, which is to improve the lives of over 500 million Europeans and possibly beyond. We live in innovative times, especially in the world of healthcare, with personalised medicine coming more and more to the fore, courtesy of groundbreaking research, new technologies and exciting developments in medical science. A major problem, however, is that making the best use of such developments in the arena of healthcare is expensive and difficult, and there are hurdles that need to be overcome. For example, regarding evaluation and approval at regulatory level.
Within this cycle, what we call the European semester, you see that both European Commission, but also the European Parliament, has been taking keen notice of the fact that healthcare has really become an important topic, and many aspects of healthcare. How do you make healthcare systems much more sustainable, and not only from a cost perspective, where we see that many member states treat the discussion around healthcare mainly from a cost perspective, but also how can you improve the access, how can you improve the quality, how can you improve the delivery time to the patient, so making sure that products get on the market in a safe way, but also in a faster way.
There are deep concerns in relation to data privacy. We've seen some serious infringements of the privacy of the individual. So that inevitably makes politicians concerned to ensure that whatever legislation they bring through the system properly protects the citizen. At the same time, however, for personalised medicine to work well and for research to work well, there needs to be an avoidance of the silo mentality. There needs to be the possibility for information to be shared in the medical and scientific community so that doctors can work together in a collaborative way so that they can get the best outcome from, for instance, information relating to the side effects of drugs. That's just one example. There are many others. But it's important, therefore, that the most information that can be made available to the medical community is made available. Therefore, when we look at the data protection regulation going through Parliament and Council at the moment, we need to ensure that there are proper derogations contained in that legislation, while on the one hand protecting the citizen in legitimate areas, but on the other hand making sure that information in relation to science and health is properly promulgated in the community so that we can all get the benefit of that.